Lincoln is my helper today. We have a birthday for Beatrice. She's turning 12, and she's only celebrated her birthday since moving in our house 5 years ago. So she's not really five, but she's only had 5 birthday parties. And it's really exciting to do this for her, and we are making a Great American Chocolate Chip Cookie Cake. So, I'm glad you joined us, and I need to go get some of the ingredients. I don't have everything I need, so we'll be back, and then we'll get this started. And since all 3 of our cars aren't working, we're gonna have to hoof it, so. Here we go, and it's a nice long walk, so you might not want to come. Okay, I don't know if you can notice, but it's a little bit darker than it was in the previous clip because the electricity just went out, which means no baking of our beloved Great American Chocolate Chip Cookie Cake. So, I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do, but I think I'm going to go ahead and put the ingredients together for you. We're doubling our recipe, so if you want to do a normal size portion for a normal size family, I suggest you cut this recipe in half, which will still feed probably 16 people. But we love cookie, and so we're going to indulge. So, all right, what you're going to need is 2 cups of butter, or in our case, 500 grams, softened, because you're going to have to mix that together. McKenna's gonna handle that. We always put our dry together and our wet, and butter is considered wet. While she does that, I'm gonna do the sugar.
Oh, do we have sugar?
Yeah, we have sugar. White sugar, which our sugar is not white. Our sugar is kind of like a tan color. 1.5, that's 1. Here we go, ready? Ooh. 1. Good enough. And a half. Oh, no. Whoa. Okay, what's a little extra sugar? Go ahead, pour it in. Sound effects are, you know, something I do. And they're pretty bad. Okay, then you need 1.5 cups of brown sugar. When you do brown sugar, you always press it in. There we go. 1.5. And you're just going to dump that all in with your butter. Then we're gonna cream it together with our mixer, but we don't have electricity, so we'll see what we can do. Here we go, dump that in. And lick my fingers. Mm. You're supposed to mix that together, but yeah, no electricity. We have a hand mixer, but I really don't think we're gonna be able to do it. Good luck.
It's gonna work.
In a separate bowl, we need 4.5 cups of baking flour, or regular, just regular old flour. Hopefully this is enough. But we don't really keep flour in the house.
Well, there's more in there.
Okay, 1. Okay, so while we were cooking lunch and trying to get that done, as well as our cookie done, some visitors showed up. These two guys spent the night with us, but now his sister's come to pick them up, as well as whisk some other people away, so yeah. My life. Now that we have our flour, you need to get 2 teaspoons of salt and then 2 teaspoons of baking soda. There's a difference between baking powder and baking soda, but anyway, sodium bicarbonate, that's what this is. It's just a raising agent for your cookies. 2 teaspoons. There we go. And you put all that in your dry stuff. And you just mix around. I use my fingers.
You can use your mixer. You can do whatever.
So we've creamed together our sugars and our butter. Now we're going to add 1 egg at a time. We're going to add 4 eggs. So this is 1, and then you mix. Again. Another 1. Yeah, so there, that's creamed together. Looks nice, doesn't it? And then we're just going to combine the 2. Before we combine the 2, I'm just turning my oven on. It should be 375 Fahrenheit or 190 degrees centigrade. There we go. And let that warm up while we work on combining these 2 in a much larger bowl. Because obviously, I don't think this is going to work. But done.
Then we're gonna have to chop up some chocolate. And if you like nuts, which I don't really like nuts myself. I mean, I like snacking on nuts, but I don't like nuts in my chewy cookies. So, I don't know if you like nuts. If you do, you can throw some walnuts in there too after we get to that point. Just gonna mix it up. You can use dough hooks if you like. I might do that. Use the dough hook setting on my mixer. BT's turning 12. I'm so excited. I'm so happy to be her mom. And so the rule in our house is the birthday girl gets to lick the beaters. We have too many people in the house to share them all. So here you go. And since I'm cooking, I should lick one too. Is that all right?
Yes.
Okay. Because, you know, there's nothing like brown sugar and butter and raw egg. Yum. Happy birthday, BT. Yummy. You're going to have a good cake, huh? Did you celebrate your birthday before coming here? No. You didn't really have any birthday parties, did you?
No.
Do you like having birthday parties? Well, heck yeah. Oh, so happy we can have a birthday party. Yum, yum. Yum, 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 yum. I decided to use my dough hooks to get this dough worked up because just doing it by hand wasn't working for me. So, I love cookie dough. Who does not like cookie dough, really? That'd be insane to not like cookie dough. Unless you're weird like Trisha and vegan or something and not eat eggs.
Cookie dough.
And then you're just missing out and it's more for us. 2 cups of chocolate chips, and these came from America. This is my last bag. Say more, please, please, Brady, please, with sugar on top. Okay. We're just gonna stir these in. Yeah. And then spreading it out in the pan is gonna be the hard part. Okay, so we're going to have to grease the pan. I don't like getting butter on my hands, and I know there's better ways, in case you wear gloves or whatever, but I'm just gonna grease it. And I have these little silicone sheets, actually, so it helps. I don't really have to grease it because of the silicone, but for your purposes, you need to see me grease it. So spreading it's tough, and that's going to be fun. So good luck with that. If you have better techniques, feel free to shoot me a message. I would love to know. I'm going to try to put butter on my spatula and just like press this cookie down. It's not gonna be so easy. This is, like I said, the hardest part is getting this all spread out nice and smooth. So now we're gonna put it in the oven for about 20 to 25 minutes and hopefully it'll get done. And while we do that, we'll work on our icing. I use a whole bag of icing sugar. This is 500 grams. It's also 4 cups. So, and if you really want to be picky about it, you can sieve it. Or, because it's a little lumpy, or you can just do what I do and not worry about it and dump it all in the bowl. So, then you need 1/2 cup of either shortening. I'm going to use coconut oil because it's a solid type fat. Icing sugar. And you'll need something nice and thick like this. You could use butter too, but it'll give it a real buttery taste. Maybe use unsalted butter. I don't know. That's up to you. But normally 1/2 cup of shortening. My goodness, it's shortening. So, I hope this bowl is big enough. Just mix it together. Let me wipe my hands off. Okay. Then we're going to put in 5 tablespoons of milk. So I'm going to put 1/4 cup, mix it up, and then see what happens after that. See how much I need. Maybe 1 more tablespoon. So, 1/4 cup. And mix it, and then you'll add that last tablespoon. Okay, I really don't have any measure. I have a measuring spoon, but it's dirty right now. So I'm gonna use this, and this will be 1 tablespoon. It's getting light and fluffy. Next, add your vanilla, maybe about 1 teaspoon. I just pour it in the cap. I always just use like a cap full to give it that nice smell.
Okay, this is Trisha. She's hanging out with me for 3 weeks. She's tasting the icing.
Oh, and that coconut. Just like a little bit. It's good. I like it. Okay, 1 more.
Did you just double dip in my icing?
No.
I don't care.
I love this. because it's regular frosting, just like regular, I don't know how to explain it. It's regular frosting because you have that little bit of just coconut in it.
It's so good.
Yeah, Johnny really likes the coconut edition.
Okay.
I'd say that's pretty.
Yeah.
While we were making the cake though, I'm making confetti for BT's birthday party. So I'm basically just using a noodle maker, a pasta maker, machine, whatever, and putting some paper through. And then cutting them into bits. So it's a good thing we got this cake done in time because the power is out again. This is Africa, right? So next we're just letting it cool for a while and then we'll ice it. We're gonna go play some games.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Ready?
These are huge pieces, people. This is not like crunchy, but
I have to get a video of everyone eating their cake.
It's good that it's soft.
Johnny, you want some? Wow. Who's missing? Husky, come. Sit. Good. Down. Good boy.
You have to put them on, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Styling.
Good. You like them?
Thank you.
We're liking them. Honestly, I would.